I know that over the last several months, I've lost a lot of things, and one of them has been my smile.
He went in the ring to announce he was retiring because he had a bad knee and didn't believe his knee was the issue. I always thought the issue was he didn't want to wrestle me at WrestleMania 13 and drop the belt to me. I doubted Shawn's integrity as far as his injury went.
You phony little faker, why don't you take your little pussyfoot injury?
I gotta choose to faking it. Bret told everybody I was faking it. My excuse is drug addicts lie all the time.
Well, there's no doubt that you found your smile again, as you stated.
A year off the wrestling business was a year no pay. Well, that's just not, that isn't feasible. And they said, well, look, you can put a brace on it, you know, and wrap it up. They went and they got me a brace and everything else. I was like, okay, I can do this.
But it is time for the Heartbreak Kid, Shawn Michaels, to return to action.
This was a moment where things needed to change. Business was bad. WCW was starting to kill us. Put Shawn and I together on TV. We will multiply each other's personalities on screen. Put us together. The X is born.
Generation X consisted of Shawn, Triple H, and China. Two goofs in Shawn and Hunter that were immature and did everything that you weren't supposed to do.
Shawn Michaels, you're a disgrace to professional wrestling.
I saw it as inmates had taken over the asylum.
I'm going to start with that degenerate right beside you in the green shirt. Suck it!
Yeah, I can't say I liked it. The smut and the crotch shots. It did get pretty raunchy.
This is what it's come down to. You're looking at somebody that's got no respect for anything.
There was a true animosity between Bret and Shawn. Just spiraled completely out of control.
In the beginning, Shawn and Bret were friends, and the antagonistic relationship that they had on camera, that was all orchestrated. But it became personal. It became personal between Bret and Shawn because one guy would go too far.
I never knew enough to avoid the confrontation if something bothered Bret. I made sure that I didn't.
He stabbed the World Wrestling Federation in the back. Why? For his financial gain.
Instead of facing me like a man, you were too busy posing for girly magazines.
You know, I know you don't like me talking about you posing for Playgirl, but you did pose for Playgirl. And we finally had a fisticuff in the dressing room.
Oh, my God, Bret and Shawn just get into a fight and pull each other's hair out in the locker room. Like, what? And run over there and find Shawn. He had a big chunk of hair missing on the side. He's like, what are you doing?
I realize that I hate your guts.
We had a lot of these resets and talks, and we would always end up offending each other quickly right after that.
What moment would you say you're most proud of? And then by the same token, what moment would you say you're least proud of?
Most proud, I guess, would be winning the world title. And least proud would probably, you know, the Montreal incident. One is everything you aspire to do, and the other is the complete opposite. Something you really don't want to be a part of.
It's the long-term guilt. It's the shame. It's the loathing that you know this person has for you.
There was so much bad blood between us, and I was always like, if I see him, I'll kill him. I've always believed that I had so much anger that I think it led to my stroke and a lot of things that I went through. And then I remember thinking about Shawn and how we were good friends once upon a time, and, you know, that it wasn't just Shawn. I was guilty, too. And I remember thinking it'd be good to put it to bed.
And I've certainly talked about my regret and the hope for reconciliation. It took him some time to get there. Vince had suggested there's got to be a way we can do this live in front of the world.
I've got 12 years of things that I've wanted to get off my chest. You want to call back there and ask Shawn Michaels to come out here? I call for a truce, and I call for you to shake my hand.
The fact that we did that in the ring and we shook hands and all that was very honest and very sincere.
You know that everybody's watching when you're trying to have this very real moment with one another. Art does imitate life.
He's matured, and he's a different guy. And I thought he finally, you know, he's got his priorities all in order.